And I want to welcome you tonight to our 2015-2016 football banquet. We're here tonight to celebrate the changing of an era, to celebrate the hard work and dedication of these young men. This past season was filled with historic moments, amazing highlights, and everyone had the opportunity to see a group of young men band together to change the perception of their school, the perception of their community, and also the perception of the football program. So as we celebrate tonight, let's not consider this a sudden moment in time, or a sudden moment in success, or like some like to say, a flash in the pan. But this is just the beginning of a lot of great things to come.
This next award is going to be the MVP on defense. But this kid, in the Carver game, I mean, we came out strong. He made some outstanding plays. But we lost him halfway through the Carver game. And, you know, for those of you who came to the game, of course, we put up a good fight. But I really felt that when this guy went down, you know, it was a, you can tell, he was out for a couple games. But when he came back, he made an immediate impact. He's very aggressive. Yes sir, no sir. He does everything I ask him to do. And again, as a defensive coordinator, I really, really love this kid because he's an emotional player. And you know, guys, you know, typically, you know, guys like to kind of take that. He wears his emotions on his sleeve. But he's a very hard-nosed kid. He can play. This kid, along with a couple of others, I wish I could change their birth certificate so I can have him another year. But our defensive MVP, Mr. Damian, I'll tell you what.
Here is the offensive MVP. You know, when you have a kid that rushed for 1,600 yards or 17 touchdowns, lightning quick, does everything you ask, signed with Morehouse, I mean, the list goes on and on. You know, we're going to truly miss him. Just not only what he was able to do on the field, he was a great kid off the field. And I wish him much success as he move on to become a Morehouse man. I look forward to sending him to Memorial Stadium during the Tuskegee Morehouse game. I'm a Tuskegee man, but I'm going to be rooting for him. The offensive MVP goes to Tyrell Smith.
This is for Mr. Smith. Congratulations.
For this next award, this is something new that we're implementing. Is the Heart of the Wave Award, and what I'm asking all coaches come forward, and also all former Greenwave players come forward.
If you don't mind, I want you to present. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm speaking in regards to the defensive side of the ball. Now this kid, I know it's a football banquet, but this kid, part of his receiving this award, because not only is he a great football player, he did everything, in my opinion, that you do off the football field as well. This kid was one of the first ones to show up. He was one of the last ones to leave. He was aggressive. He's an outstanding football player. He's just an all-around young man. I love him. I pray for him, man, and I know he's going to do well. Every time I see him,
Well, when you start talking about the heart of the wave, Coach Bynum kind of, you know, summed it up. This kid has a 3-0. He is a multi-sport athlete. Since I've been involved in Spencer Athletics for 13 months, I don't know if I've ever had to fuss at this guy. We're going to miss him. I'm so proud he's going to be a Tuskegee Golden Tiger. And this award goes to DeShay Hubbard.
I want to thank Principal Freeman, Coach Coffey and his staff, family and friends for inviting me to be the first speaker of this historic turnaround. I'm so excited to be a part of it. So let's please give yourselves a hand. There is a number of ways I can start this conversation. The first way I would love to start it is 1989, we were playing the Carver Tigers. We had lost to them 3 years in a row. And I was sick and tired of it. My teammates were sick and tired of it. So we decided that this was our year. We were going to beat the Carver Tigers, who was ranked really, really high. That was the year they beat Valdosta. So they really were really good. My teammates, Gary Downs, Jerome Gardner, Reggie Johnson, great guys, all got college degrees, all doing well in the military. I mean, just a number of guys. We band together for one game. We probably won 4 games that season, but for this one game, with a tight game on the line, Coach Matthews, who was our coach at the time, called a running play, and I was on the sideline when he called the play, and he said, Fuller, you're supposed to be in there. And I said, what's the play? By that time, he had pushed me out there. I was halfway out there. So I get out to the field, and Jerome Gardner's lined up behind the quarterback. Gary Downs lined up to my left. And I look over, and I say, Gary, what's the play? He's like, 48, blah, blah, blah. By that time, they were snapping the ball. I say, which way are we going? He was like, left. And I was like, who's getting the ball? You! I was like, okay! So I received the ball and I took 2 steps and daylight opened on my right side. I turned, I shot through the hole, I ran 80 yards to score the game-winning touchdown to beat the Carver Tigers. So all my Carver friends, they always highlight the Carver Tigers, but I say, but that senior year, we did pull off a win. So I wanted to tell you that story because that was the last time I attended a Carver Spencer game prior to this year, or 2015. Now what I saw when I came back impressed me so much that I was excited to want to plug back into a relationship with the Spencer Greenwaves again. I felt like,
thank you.
I felt like this was home. So the reason I'm standing here today is because this is home. You don't have to, when you invite me or the alumni from Spencer, when you invite us back, we come back. You know, you don't have to pull on us to do it. Yes, I wanted to celebrate my daughter's birthday with her, but I knew she'd rather watch The Lion King on Broadway than hang out with me at a banquet, because I was going to bring her. So that wasn't going to work. But Coach Coffee, who I met at that Carver Spencer game, he let me give the pregame speech. And I can't remember what I said, but my godfather Monk said I did a great job. And for 3.5 quarters, the Carver Tigers were sweating like no other. I mean, my friends, they wouldn't even text, they wouldn't say anything. I was like, I didn't know you was at the game. They're like, yeah, I was there. But they couldn't say anything for 3.5 quarters. So I'm excited about this coaching staff turning this program around, Principal Freeman taking Spencer to greater heights, and I just can't wait to see where we're going. So let's please give them a round of applause.
One of the things that y'all know that I went on at Spencer High School this year, we were talking one day, and I said, Coach Coffee, I said, we got to really get the staff excited about the football program. And we were trying to find ways to get everybody involved. So what we did was we asked every member in our building, every teacher, every paraprof, everybody in our building, to adopt a football player. So adopting a football player meant that you had to follow him or her, follow him on his grade. You had to make sure you come out to the games and support them. You actually had to buy them lunch from time to time, buy them goodie bags, and hold nine. So I want to thank all the teachers and all the people that adopted our kids. We have 10 seniors that signed college scholarships. Yes, yes, clap that up. And we have another one that's coming up. Okay? Seniors, thank you so much. Very proud of you. Everyone who came out tonight, hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for all that you do. God bless y'all.